Welcome everyone to the Inside Java Newscast, where we cover recent developments in the OpenJDK community. I'm Nikolai Parlock, Java Developer Advocate at Oracle, and today I got three topics for you.
Wow, three.
First, incremental evolution of the platform, how the 6-month release cadence makes introducing new features or transitioning out of old ones much smoother. Second, pattern switches and sealed classes, how you can combine these two features to maintainably add operations to types without modifying them,
and get rid of the visitor pattern.
Third, native Wayland support. Ready? Then let's dive right in. When Java had a big release every 2 to 3 years, its evolution was necessarily pretty abrupt. Take Lambda, Streams, and Optional, for example. They all benefit from one another and showed up in the same release, Java 8. That makes it easier for the developer to see their benefit, but it also means that they all need to fit together from day one. Little chance for the JDK team to gather practical feedback, little chance to evolve features according to their use. That changed in 2017 with the switch to the 6-month release cadence. Take Panama as an example. Project Panama is improving and enriching the connections between the Java virtual machine and non-Java APIs, meaning native code. In short, it wants to replace JNI, and it already made a lot of headway. In JDK 14, it started incubating the Foreign Memory Access API that saw some major changes and improvements since then. The other big portion, Foreign Function Support, started incubating JDK 16. In the upcoming JDK 17, both APIs are incubating together, and there's a decent chance that they will be finalized next year. A very helpful tool that the project created, called JExtract, is not even part of the JDK yet. That may come later. Panama greatly benefited from being able to pre-release its APIs early, so it was easier to experiment with and give feedback on. This only makes sense if the next version is only a few months out, which was possible due to the frequent releases. By the way, if you're interested in the current state of Project Panama, check out my recent conversation with its lead Maurizio Cimadamore. Should be up there, I guess. The frequent releases not only help with additions though, they also help with the occasional deprecation or removal. Albeit not fitting those terms exactly, store encapsulation is a good example for something going away over the course of multiple releases. JDK 9 introduced the mechanism that would finally lock away the JDK's internal APIs that we've been using for about 2 decades. But to ease migration, it wasn't on by default. Instead, it introduced the temporary command line flag illegal access that manages runtime access to internal APIs. On JDK 9, the default value was warn, which effectively suspended store encapsulation at runtime, but let developers know that things are about to change. Which is what happened in JDK 16. Now denies the default value, so you get exceptions when accessing internal APIs. You can work around that by adding the illegal access flag to your launch script, but don't get used to that. In 17, all values will behave like deny, so there's no longer a blanket kill switch for store encapsulation. I know store encapsulation can be a touchy topic. By the way, to get a deeper insight, I recommend the recent Inside Java podcast with Alan Baton on this very topic. What I want to highlight here is how a frequently released platform can make changes like these less abrupt and easier to adapt to. And by staying on the most recent release, or at least compiling or testing against it, you can make sure that you can see the impact such changes have on your codebase as early as possible. Bonus points for building against the early access builds, you can get started with JDK 18, yes 18, today. Okay, enough boring cleanup, let's do something fun. Pattern matching. Pattern matching started with type patterns for instance of, first previewed in JDK 14. Since then it has been refined and finalized in 16. In 17, as a preview, patterns make the jump to switch. Because starting in 12, switched evolved from the good old statement we all know to become more than that. It has a form without fall through, it can be an expression, and it can check whether the branches cover all possible cases. That is called exhaustiveness or completeness. These are important preparations for accommodating patterns. Completeness is particularly helpful because it lets you elide the default branch, which not only removes effectively dead code if all cases are already covered explicitly, it also allows you to provoke a compile error if a new case is needed. From what I've talked about so far, that would only work well with enums though. But there's a third path leading here, and that is sealed classes. First previewed in 15, refined in 16, and finalized in 17, they allow us to express a closed inheritance hierarchy. This enables the compiler to extend completeness checks beyond enums to type hierarchies, but more on that in a minute. Because I'm not done with pattern matching yet, and neither is Project Amber. Over the coming releases, we can expect to see more than just type patterns. The construction patterns for arrays and records are next in the pipeline, both candidates for a preview in JDK 18. I also assume that we'll eventually see APIs that are best interacted with via pattern matching. More on all of that in another recent Inside Java podcast episode, this one with Gavin Bierman on pattern matching. These changes are very diverse. They expand existing language features and introduce new ones. Arguably, this is more to explore and learn than lambda expressions of the module system, for example, because it's less monolithic. Being able to create and adopt this one by one instead of in one big chunk in a single release makes this a bit easier. Let's have a bit of a closer look at pattern switches and sealed classes. They come from Java Enhancement Proposals 4.6 and 4.9. As usual, links to this and everything else I mentioned in the description. If you scroll down to check it out, I'd appreciate if you leave a like so more Java devs get to see this video. Let's imagine a shape interface that has two implementations, circle and rectangle. Now we want to compute a shape's area. You may think about adding a new method area to shape, but no! I'll come back to this later, I promise. Instead, we create that operation as a method somewhere that gets a shape and switches over its type to determine how to compute the area. So it's double area equals switch over shape with case circle C call compute circle area C and case rectangle R call compute rectangle area R. Unfortunately, that is not enough. The pattern switch needs to be complete, and so we have to add either a case shape or a default branch. This works, but it has a serious problem. When we add new shapes, say triangle, we need to find and update all switches to include it if we don't want it to be handled by the default branch. That's why these runtime checks for types have a bad name. They are basically impossible to maintain. And that's why your first idea was probably a method area on shape, which is and remains the default choice. In cases where that's not possible, maybe you don't want to overload the types with too many disconnected features, the visitor pattern is usually the next choice. I'm not going to explain it here, but suffice it to say that in its common form, the visitor pattern will give you a compile error when you add a new shape, which is good because it means you need to update all operations to handle the shape properly. But thanks to sealed classes, that's also possible for pattern switches. By writing sealed interface shape permits circle rectangle, we restrict shape's inheritance hierarchy to the known subtypes circle and rectangle. Then we can go back to our switch in area. It covers the cases circle and rectangle, and the compiler knows that only those two types can directly implement shape. So even without the default branch, the switch is complete, and indeed that means that we can remove the default. This is big. Now when we add a new type, such switches are no longer complete and don't compile. That means, with regards to maintainability, a pattern switch over sealed classes works just as well as the visitor pattern. I could go on to compare the two solutions and come to the conclusion that I think this modern approach makes the visitor pattern obsolete, but I've already written a blog post that does exactly that and led to some energetic conversations about what the pattern really is about and what use cases remain. Relitigating all of that here would take way too long, but if you're interested, I leave links to the blog post, the Twitter conversation, and the Reddit thread below. All I want you to take away from this is that pattern switches and sealed classes offer an alternative to the visitor pattern that may be worth exploring. WayNet is a display server for Linux, the thing your desktop environment uses to draw all over the screen. Wayland is on its way to replace the venerable X-Windows system, also called X11. Last week, Philip Reis, developer at the Java platform group at Oracle, sent a mail to the OpenJDK Discuss mailing list where he wrote, got new shades for my birthday, got new shades for... We expect quite shortly to propose an OpenJDK project that will consider the goals of a short to medium term solution for JDK running on Wayland and X11 compatibility mode, and a medium to long term solution for JDK running as a native Wayland client. The feedback has been very positive, so I'm sure we'll hear more about this in the future. That's it, that's all I can say at the moment. I thought I'd add it to the newscast since, after all, this is the year of Java on Linux on the desktop, right? Right? And that's it for today on the Inside Java newscast. If you have any questions about what I covered in this episode, ask ahead in the comments below. And if you enjoy this kind of content, help us spread the word with a like or by sharing this video with your friends and colleagues. I'll see you again in 2 weeks. So long!